final. This is amazing. Look at this beautiful. This is the Western Wall. This is where Jews have been coming to pray for 2,000 years. This place represents the closest that we can get to the Temple Mount where the Holy Temple stood. So people come to pray at the base of this wall, which is the retaining wall of the Temple Mount. And their prayers have been going up for 2,000 years that God should speedily come and help us bring redemption so that we can have this third temple rebuilt soon. But there are still stones in this wall that were put together from Herod's time that we're going to go look at. And if we get closer to the wall, I'll explain to you some of the things that we can't see from here. This revered wall has seen a lot of tears from a lot of people, a lot of prayers. Represents only a small, small piece of the hopes of and dreams of the people who have been waiting since they've been exiled from their land to be able to come back and rebuild and be able to serve their God the way that they were told to. But I've shown them, look, you see these papers here? All inside the cracks of the wall, all the way through here. People come from all over the world to leave these papers here, asking for something from the Master of the Universe. And they leave these papers here to remind him, please, please, my health, my family, my livelihood, whatever.
So this is God's post office box.
So these are the walls that Herod built. The outside walls of the Western Wall where people come and pray.
We know that from the borders around the outside. See, everywhere we've traveled in the country, I've seen these borders.
These borders represent, they're a signature of Herod the Builder. All the places that he built in Hebron, in Caesarea, here in Jerusalem, in Masada, all the places where he built and he put his bevel, his famous bevel around the edges.
For years I looked here and I saw where my face went, my head. And I figured I was on top of the sweat and the tear line here on the coast.
No, that's not a sweat and a tear. This is the line that marks that where the ground was up to this level until the Israelis took over this in 67, and they excavated all the way down to the level that we're on. This was all below ground.
The sweat on people's arms, and the sweat on their heads.
Has nothing to do with it at all. Now, you notice these plants here, and those? These are the capers. You can see the fresh capers on them. Isn't that unbelievable?
Well, these I know, they're the plants that they talk about in the Gemara, in the oral law.
That's right.
They have four different qualities to them. They have a flower, they have a seed, they have a leaf, and they have a stem, and they're all edible.
That's right.
And the question is, what blessing do you say on such a plant? The oral law talks in very great depth about this plant because it's unique in that way.
Unbelievable. Just beautiful.
Isn't it?